Welcome back to another episode of The Witcher with me, Magix. And in this episode, we are finally going to enter the crypt. So stay tuned and let's go.
Push the goddamn button!
You heard what she said.
So, welcome back. We are just continuing where we left off in the last episode, and yeah, we are just outside the town again after we have lit up all the shrines, and we are still searching for a merchant to sell some of our stuff. Maybe you? Let's see. No, he doesn't want our skulls, so that one is kind of useless, but now I haven't checked his inventory. No, this is just for plants, so never mind. Let's quickly check the inn. There was this alchemy guy, and he was sitting here, but I can't find him right now. Antiquary, well. He doesn't want our stuff, but there is still some books we haven't bought before. Argest. I'm searching for the book for the ghouls. This is only for swamp monsters. No, this is not what we are searching for right here. There's another merchant. Let's see. No. This is Sultan. Ah. Yeah. Let's see. Nice, okay, we've got a new quest actually. While I was searching for a damn merchant or what have you. And since I can't find one now, well, let's just store these skulls, I guess. Maybe sell them later. Probably also don't need the rings right now. Let's keep one in case we find finally someone that can pick them up. And I guess this would be the same guy that then wants our valuable diamonds. And what else can we dump here? Here are more skulls. So we have freed up at least some of our inventory. Well, I don't think we need two of those shawls, so let's put one back. And yeah, the flint is also not very useful, but I guess it's fine for now. This should be good enough. Okay. Let's quickly reorganize. And then let's venture to the entrance, actually, I guess. Let's quickly check them again. Yeah, nothing he really wants. Maybe we can dump some of the flints by the blacksmith. Our dwarven friend right here. Yes. Unfortunately, no. Never asked that before. Okay. And let's just continue outside. Please. let's see. So we have the quest for the cave note 2. There's still the drowners there. Yeah, let's go to the crypt actually now. Want some action here, right? But we have to run there. Let's pick up some herbs on the way. Even though I feel like the bottleneck right now is the alcohol, actually, to create those potions. And not the actual herbs. Because you can gather as much as you want outside, so... Let's quickly check Abigail. I think she had some books. Because if I don't find the book right now... I will spend the talent point, actually. The book for the ghouls. This is only for the swamp monsters. Field plants, bar guests, no. So, seems like we have to put the point into the skill to get the blood, actually. We are very near now. So, grabbing the last plants here. And there was also a rune of power, of course. We can pick that up too. So our push rune is better. Or stun rune. Oh, this should be fine. Yeah, there's the crypt is. Come on. Just pick the stuff up. There is a fireplace too. And there is a rune. So, what would you like to do? Well, that's obvious, right? Hmm. But now... It will only last for 4 hours, right? And we still have to rest somewhat, so we have to maybe do it again. Anyways. Where was the talent? Intelligence. Monster lore. Okay, so we have made that. I think we have made most... potions in the last episode. Don't need that much more right now. So, yeah, let's wait till midnight. Set the atmosphere for entering this nice little dungeon. So, yeah. And we are already under attack. You can see that we have a lot of new journey entrants, and especially the ghoul blood. That's important. So we don't need the books anymore for this stuff, and save some money. So let's check if we can still... Yes, we can still use this place of power. So... Good. There are enemies coming already, trying to block our entry into the crypt. Okay, got them. And yeah, we can now also gather death dust from them. Maybe we you should grab this talent earlier, so you can increase the loot you find. Well... And then let's see, we still want to try out this unknown potion, right? Let's see what it does. Well, there was no visible effect. was white honey, and this one reduces toxicity. Well, good, we have used this right now, because it cancels all the effect of other potions. But this fixes our alcohol issues. Ace used to make other potions. Also, we don't need the wild gull. I think we want to try out the cat. And the others are only there in a single, so let's quickly save. And then let me venture into it. First time. Let's go, the crypts. Poor girl. Dark areas. Drink the cat potion or light a torch. Yeah. So I can already see a ghoul in the distance. Well, let's use this strong style then. And it's getting pretty dark in here. I have to use this potion probably, because if I use the other item, well, this is already dangerous. The right one was hurt, so let's try to focus this one, actually. Yes, got him. It's funny how it's how there is light outside, even though we enter it at midnight, so... Okay, now we can loot the remains for the ghoul bloods. Must have lured the ghouls. Okay, so there's nothing to loot. And if we now use the torch, okay. We can see a little bit better, but if I then use the sword, yeah, you can't fight that well with a stem torch, so it's not that useful actually. I'm afraid of the darkness. Come into the light, my friend. Good. You need the combos. Can't let him attack. Good. And then let's use the cat potion, actually. Yeah, and now it becomes a lot better to see. Nice potion, actually. And we finished the ghoul contract already. This is there for 7 hours. Okay. And another place of power. But we already have the buff on. So no use. Oh, and we find a circle of inner fire. That are a lot of enemies. 3 at the same time. This will be dangerous. Come on. Beat 1. I couldn't use the push, actually. This was it. Yes, coup de grace. But we are taking a lot of damage while doing so. I kind of need to press one down. Yes, like this. Whenever I try the push, my vision kind of gets dark for a fraction of time, but then you can actually use the finishing move. So, it's probably worth it. Now let's loot here. And I need to heal, actually. But they are giving us a lot of experience. We have already made half a level. So, yeah, let's finally make use of our food here. This, yeah, it's only lasting for a few minutes. But you can see that our health bar is slowly going up. And it seems like if we take potions, then our toxicity is rising. So you can only have so much buffs at the same time. Just another dice box, flint, orange, and some more healing stuff. Well, we find our next rune, Igni. This one lights fire, so we don't need our flints soon, because we can use our fire spells to light up the fireplaces. And let's continue eating to regenerate more health. What now? Well, this one has lost his leg. Like we are eating chicken legs. The ghouls probably eat those legs, human legs. But there is nothing else here. So, where to continue, actually? New region corridor, but. Ah! Wait, I just remembered. Well, this didn't work. Anyways, let's quickly eat again. Because there was in the tutorial the situation where you could blast off these rocks actually with your push. Well. But this didn't work this time. So maybe I was missing something here. Is there a hidden path in here? No. That's odd. There has to be another way, right? There's nothing on the girl, no. Because we have only finished the Ghoul Blood quest. These are all the tutorials we have gained. As well, we already know about Fist Fight, we will know about these floating messages. Yeah, gifts, sure. Inns and taverns, we already know that. Drinking, we all know that already. The poker, dark areas, alchemy, blacksmith, bribe, campfires, and yeah, there is nothing new in here. Notice board. Okay. Skinning monsters, so. Quests. I have fun. Oh, yeah, this is a new quest, okay. I managed to kill the ghouls. So, seems like we have already finished this. Which is odd, because I can still see a ghoul behind this, but I can't go deeper into it, seems like. Or my rune is not strong enough to blast these rocks away. I can see on the map that there is still a way right there, but oh, we can't reach it. Or there's another entrance, I'm not sure. Seems to be everything here so far. Well, let's leave. Heal up a bit more. And, well. Maybe you can go up this hill. Good. Yeah, the Baguette seems to be the easiest enemies. Well, but I don't see another entrance in there, so. If I missed something, maybe you can write it in the comments section, because I'm not sure. So I guess now the next thing to do is either try to beat the drawners or to go into the cave. Good. Let's continue. What now? Oh, the big red dog again. Maybe we have to beat this red dog at one point. Seems to be the beast, or how they did call it. So we can go up to the Merchant's Gate now and try to get one quest in. Well, there comes another one. But they are easy now. It only takes always a few seconds to finally loot someone. So, anyways, let's run. I don't loot this plants right now because we need more alcohol actually. And we can heal up a little bit more. Let's use up the small stacks first. So maybe we can make another level if we turn in the quest. Yeah, there are coming more of them. Under the full moon. Good, got them. Sooner or later we will find a trader to loot them. Try to sell this loot, so... What's now? This is a guy we have to give the cool blood. Uh-oh. What now? Hi! Wait, do we fight now the boss too? How the guards in the back are not helping us. That's cute. I have to get used to this new group fending style. Ah, but they are helping us now. Okay, so this one is a mage. Let's use the fast style to pressure him. But I have to get my combos off. And we have help. Good. Protected our quest giver. No problem. Well, it's hard to say. I'm not sure if the game changes if you fight the Frightener in the beginning. So, nope.
pages.
Nice. Hey, I want to turn my quest in. Well, well, at least we've completed the quest. And 200 orans, not nice. That's nice, yeah. Well, we have your blood. Well, yeah. Another quest finished. Nice. What brings you here? Maybe? No. Nothing to trade, unfortunately. So, let's heal up a little bit. And a lot to loot here. Salamander brooch. Okay. Sure. Maybe we can sell those. Unsure if we really need this other sword. Well, I don't need this torch, that's for sure. Get all of this and then see if we can fight the swamp beasts. There are more remains even. Ah, but only these daggers. And I think, yeah, there is nothing to pick up here. We already got them, so. But the damage is not very high. Okay, what about the quests now? Okay, this is the cavern quest. We still have to find Berengar. Any money playing? Okay, so this is like a continued quest. We did light the fires already. So we have still to kill the drowners, go into the cave. Yeah, this is also the drowners. And only Heron is left. And the professor, okay. Let's see, they should be around the water here, actually. That's what the NPCs said in the last episode. But I still wonder how you can fight them. the most efficiently need a specific style for them. Let's see. Maybe, since we have the information here, monsters. This is Drawner, actually. They appear on the banks of ponds, lakes, and rivers. Immune to bleeding, blinding, poison. Immune to stun, so this is good to know. Yeah, silver we don't have. Fast style, so good. It's the same like the Barghest, actually. Or the group style against multiples, of course. Dance around him. Strong style was indeed good against the ghouls. Gravier. Also strong, yeah. Seems like if the opponent looks more sturdy, you have to use the strong style indeed. We haven't faced those so far, but they are also in the swamps, so... And this is important to know, a dying Bloodseeker explodes. Yeah, so we have to be able to evade. But they are also susceptible against the... Group style, actually, okay. A strong style, no. Group style is only if you face more. So, yeah, we have to use the fast style, actually. And there's are the drawners. Well then. Bring it! You are the first drawner we face. You look ugly, my friend. Beaten our first one. And evaded skillfully the attack of the second one. Good, but here are coming more. The other... There's the left one looks differently, but... It's just a drawner in the end. Come on. Don't be a chicken and come at me. Good. We have won the fights and can loot the brains. We need a few of those. I think three. Good. Finish the contract. There are coming more. Come on. Hopefully I can loot the one in the water still. Wow, there are even more coming. And more, and more. Lots of drawners. And our sword is full of blood. Yes, we have finished the quest. Well, what do we do? We need kind of the approval of Varen. But the elves are nearly extinct, right? So, I guess, yeah, fine. Okay. So, we've got some gold. Let's gather the brains. Can use them in some potions, probably. And luckily we can loot the ones that were killed in the water. Tier. We have still some time on our cat buff. So we can probably also go to the cave now. It starts raining. Let's see if we can turn the quest in, actually. It was this way. Yes. Okay, so no harm that we shared the crates. Good. Yeah, and finished another quest. So, only thing left now is to speak with the Reverend and visit the cave, I guess. Let's go this direction. Maybe I'm walking wrong right now. That should be around the corner, actually. What now? You again? You're going on my nerves. Fight me, finally. Yeah, it's a beast. Maybe finally it's time. No, he vanished. There are even more bar guests. And there are also drawners, I think, yeah. Exactly. Well then, Mr. Drawner, I'm here for you. Yeah, they are easier than the ghouls, actually. So I guess you can do them before the crypt. But you definitely know how to loot them. Because else you can't finish the quests. Well, okay. So you could jump into the water. Can you then also cross? No, you can't cross to the mill. Unfortunately. Okay. Anyways, he wanted to go to the Reverend and tell him about lighting up the fires, killing the drowners, and finishing all the trust quests. And lots of bug guests. They are annoying. They are too easy now. But are still coming all the time. Yeah, figured it. Good. Okay, the Reverence House was this one. So let's wake him up. So, yep. Ah, so now we have to beat the beast, anyways. Good. And finish another quest. And a level gained. But that's not all. We have done a lot more. Give me money. Okay. There are a lot more options. Well, okay, so we have to still finish the quests to get this damn pass. Anyways, we have still the cat buff on. 4 hours is a lot. I figure since we have to go to the witch, here, the cave is kind of on the way. So, let's go to the cave then. Check it out. And then we can go to the witch afterwards. Yeah, a lot of birds in the darkness. Yeah, this way was correct. Just takes a little bit to run there. No bar guests so far. They shouldn't say it too loudly. Oh yeah, and we have to speak to the hunter that we killed some drawners. Anyways, this is the direction to the cave. Well, here they come. Good. They were easy. Let's continue to the cave. What about our buff? Yeah, it's still 1 hour on. What now? Here comes the beast. Do you want to fight now? Nope. They don't even give that much experience anymore. Okay. Circle of Windy Wanderer. Is this another magic rune? Yeah, it is. Blessing of Air. Art sign intensity increased by 50%. Not bad. So, let's make use of all of this. And we can still buff the regeneration. Yeah, and then let's go into the cave, right? Let's see if we face like a super monster in here. Well, okay. Looks more like a bandit side out. New regent cave, yeah, sure. And the new regent. Mushrooms. Okay. Well, only one way to go so far. Again, there is nothing really in here. And there has to be a trick to get these damn boulders out of the way. So odd. Is there another way? Maybe here? Oh. This was the entrance already. So, feels like I'm too dumb. But I don't know how to continue here. I mean, I can just go in this direction, look in it, and try to push. But it's no use. Can try the ignis sign. Oh yeah, but this is just a fire. So break down doors and gates and destroy barriers. Yeah, but well, I can see on the map that there is a way or something, but seems like we can't do anything right now here. Or you have to come back at a specific time, I'm not sure. Maybe I have to look it up. Because it's getting, yeah, it's no longer midnight. The morning is coming, or dawn, so there is also the corpse. Well, maybe this was the corpse we were actually looking for, I'm not sure. Yeah, no, it's daytime again. Let's go to the hunter, maybe we can now turn in the killed drowners. And wizard the witch. The royal huntsman. It was the guy we've talked to before. So it seems you can't take in a yeah, bring him Drowner Brains to get those 80 orans. It's more like he get paid 80. Well, we only get paid, what was it, 100 for 3 or something like that. So, yeah. Anyways, let's try to visit the witch to get rid of the beast. Okay. Wake up, girl. We can also try. Yeah, you can sell the brains here actually, but only for one, so we don't get much out of this deal. We could buy some alcohol in here to make new potions. Probably try around a little bit. And some more powder and stuff. Maybe you need bombs to actually continue through the cave and stuff. Anyways. Well, we already gathered enough herbs. So, so Elvin is already here. Yeah, come on, don't go to sleep now. We have to make the boy speak. Come on, wake her up. So maybe go out, go in. That will do the trick, maybe. Speak. Hellhound soul, okay. Contain the formula for potion made using traces left by the hellhound. Ah, so we get one silver talent when we consume it. But we have to kill the hellhound first, so. Let's check the quest log here. Yeah, okay, so we have to go back to the Reverend actually. We have to do this. because I can't go into the cave somehow. Yeah, this direction. We don't need more flint. So good thing I have gathered up these white myrtles before, saved some time. Let's see, there's a merchant. Okay, he doesn't want to trade. So we have to run all the way back. And then let's see what the Reverend says about skinned puppies. What these monsters are doing in the villages. To the poor doggies. So the Bargess only want revenge for becoming skinned or something like that, maybe. So much for a holy church. They mishandling animals. Oh. Need something like a horse or what have you to travel faster. That would be nice. Like a mount. Anyways, let's... Yeah, there he is. Let's speak to the Reverend. Oh, he was just there, right? Yes, I want to speak to you. Okay. Time to deal with the salamandra then. So we have to go to the inn where it all started in chapter 1. Here I probably don't need the cat's potion for this. But it's not far away. Yeah, just around the corner. This seems to be like the salamandra's key house. So we only need the key to those. Locked doors. Yeah, there's a salamandra lackey. Maybe let's see what happens if I approach him now. Here he comes. Let's use the strong style for this. Good. Here comes another one. You look exactly the same. Maybe I just killed your brother. But now you are dead, my friend. Yep, get some money. It seems like we can go in now. Oh, wait, I need the group style here. For some mass murdering of bandits. Yes, like this. And just need to hit this flaming sword. Yeah, sure, you can try it. This is a boss, actually. There's a lot of blood on this damn floor. Damn it, we have actually lost. I didn't expect this. So using the group style was fine, but then I should have switched to the other style more quickly. So we have to try this again, or I have to use more of the runes. You can try it. Yeah, the strong style is definitely the correct one. Okay. This time I will heal up. Come on. Eat this, Geralt. What else can we use? What about the Blizzard potion? Blizzard. Yeah, let's use it now. And the Swallow potion. But we are now getting intoxicated. Maybe it's bad now, but look at our health going up very quickly now. Most of these last at least a little bit. Yeah, but the blizzard is only lasting, yeah, like an hour or something. But our health is now up. Anyways, I will put this buff on. Yeah, but it's getting slow now. Anyways, let's try it. And let's switch to the group style, actually. And everything is getting slow now. So our senses seem to be enhanced a lot. And it's only one. Damn it, it was too fast. I have to be careful here. Good, so let's switch to the strong style and let's try this in slow motion thanks to our blizzard potion, it seems like. And this makes it easier to get the combos off, and this was it. We have beaten the boss. Man, this was a strong potion, actually. Now let's put this away. Let's see what we have. What's our reward, so to say? What we have found here? Well, nothing with you, nothing with you. Just a little bit here. Unfortunately, this was kind of it. Probably not worth this damn potion. But I surely like the effect. Oh, there's a trapdoor, actually. Well, let's check out the containers. Well, only flint. Maybe this is like a hidden way in the cave or what? Huh. So, we have learned a little secret, seems like. Well, yeah, nothing here really. What was that? Well, okay, let's go to the inn first. Yeah, now the buff is off and the slow motion is gone. But it was surely a nice potion. So it seems like the trader has lied to us. There is no update here. Yeah. The villagers know. This guy from the docks is actually trading with them, so we can also go to him and ask him a little bit about the situation. Okay. Well, here we go in. Troublemakers. Well, let's see what is happening here. The innkeeper is dead. Oh no, our loot. Okay, group style, here we go, eh? Let's have to exactly hit this. Nice. Good. There's a combo. And again. Now for the final tech. Well, he's already dead. Well, they are easier than ghouls, that's for sure. This should do it. Yeah, all loot. Yep. That's what we do with every dead person. Checking the loot. Salam Stemmelfort's dust, okay. Well, it's a light club. Okay. Let's see that innkeeper. There's a key to the salamander's hideout. Well, just some food, I guess. But we have lost all the stuff we have given to the innkeeper, so I hope that other innkeepers share this storeway, kind of. Because else it would be really bad. Well, and now we have to find the right home, it seems like, and maybe the guy in the docks or at the docks knows more about this. Anyways, let's level up. let's see, we have 6 bronze talents. We can probably improve our art rune, which causes knockdown then. Yeah, stun is also not bad. Student, apprentice, angle 90 degrees. No, should be fine for now. What about the Igni rune? Attacks from a distance, okay. Well, this is a nice damage buff, but I'm not sure we need it right now. What about Strange? This could be nice. There was this upgrade where you gain a lot of damage if you go somewhere midnight. That could be nice. Deflect arrows. Pearl is also not bad. Here, Predator. This was it. Requires consumption of a mutagen. Well, okay. So we can't learn it right now. Well, I guess deflect arrows is nice. Repel, yeah, sure. Well, mutation. Okay, so you can eat ingredients to restore vitality. Oh, yeah. Laces of power twice daily, okay. Poison resistance, well. Endurance regeneration, that's probably okay. Yeah, let's go with this for now. I wonder if we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, level 8 right now. And if these are full, you get finally silver talents or something. Yeah, we can still. Next time we can try this oil preparation skill, so we can make oils actually. And yeah, doing moon rises we gain more power, but this is very conditional, so. Forming places of power, okay. Extraction. So these attributes, talents seem very useful all in all. And maybe increase the power of our Igni rune. And maybe some more points into art, but yeah, I guess we have mostly gathered all the good bronze talents, because these are rather mediocre, or only useful if you are nearly dead, so I guess it's fine if you don't have them right now. Yeah, maybe these precise hits are still good. Because the group style seems very useful. Because it feels like if you face several opponents, this is far more dangerous than if you face a single opponent. But we also have to still use some bronze talents on our silver sword, which we might gain at one point, so yeah, but we'll probably get more bronze talents later on also. Yeah, still until level 15 you get a lot of bronze points, so should be good. Get our upgrades here. Yeah, so we have become even stronger. Should maybe check if we could make some more potions. But anyways, let's wrap the episode up here. I hope you enjoyed it. And yeah, wish you a nice day. And see you next time. Bye bye.